These drivers lost control at very high speeds. The result was tragic for one driver and fortunate for the others. But why? What made the difference between walking away and being carried away? The answer can be found in some of the most basic laws of the physical universe.
Now, what about a body in motion? Am I a body in motion? You bet I am. I'm moving 35 miles per hour. But from one perspective, it may not look like I'm moving at all, because in relationship to the passenger compartment, my position isn't changing. But if you look at me from the outside, you can see that I'm moving at the same speed as the vehicle, in this case, about 35 miles per hour. Now, what does this mean to occupants of a moving vehicle? Watch this.
See how the car and the crash test dummy are traveling at the same speed? Now watch what happens when the car crashes into the barrier. The front end of the car is crushing and absorbing energy, which slows down the rest of the car. But the dummy inside keeps on moving at its original speed until it strikes the steering wheel and windshield.
This is because the dummy is a body in motion traveling at 35 miles per hour and remains traveling 35 miles per hour in the same direction until acted upon by an outside force.
In this case, it's the impact of the steering wheel and windshield that applies the force that overcomes the dummy's inertia. If you're wearing your seatbelt, you slow down with the occupant compartment as the vehicle's front end does its job of crumpling and absorbing crash forces.
Here's my favorite demonstration. I have two eggs, same mass. I'm going to try to throw each egg with the same velocity. That means they have the same momentum. Why do we have such dramatically different results? The wall applies a big stopping force over a short time. The sheet applies a smaller stopping force over a longer time period. My students say the sheet has more give to it. Extending the time of impact is the basis for many of the ideas about keeping people safe in crashes. It's the reason for airbags and crumple zones in the vehicles you drive. It's the reason for crash cushions and breakaway utility poles on our highway. And it's the answer to the question I posed at the beginning of this film. This driver survived the crash because his deceleration from high speed took place over a number of seconds. This driver decelerated in a small fraction of a second and experienced forces that are often unsurvivable.